This is a really important question because I think this is where organizations get a little lost and get overwhelmed, is in sort of, I always joke about shiny object syndrome. Just because it's new doesn't mean it's good for you, or helpful or productive or useful in any way. It's very unlikely that anybody in this room needs to be a first adopter of most of these technologies. There is very little value to being the first person into a room on the internet. There is, right, it's the dumbest person in the world is the first person to buy a fax machine. Same idea, right? Until there's a community here, until there are people here to activate, there's not a lot of reason to start expending massive amounts of resources on building relationships if there's nobody there. And so the value of novelty is much lower than you might think. And just because someone wrote a really awesome article on Mashable does not mean that it is the most important strategic imperative for your organization tomorrow. But it's really important for you to realize that every one of these platforms was designed as a relationship mechanism.
As an organization, it is not your job to be on the next thing. It's your job to be on today's thing and where your people are right now. I think there's an incredible opportunity to use Twitter to actually establish a leadership position. You know, when you're actually talking about things, and, all right, no one else actually knows what they're talking about, but you do. That's when it's extremely valuable.
I think we have a tendency when we talk about digital to start with, you know, how do we use Twitter more effectively, rather than the questions about who are we and what are we trying to achieve and how are we trying to empower people, and then thinking about the tools as the ways to deliver on those promises that are more about values and mission first, and then you sort of go through a strategic process, and then you start talking about which tactics apply to the mission that we're on.
The first step is listening to what people are saying, what people are, how people are interacting. I mean, I don't think you can jump into any of this without having, to some extent, having had that experience yourself. Now that the publishing platforms are essentially available to everybody, everybody can dip their toe in the water. And I think oftentimes the really genuine uses of these platforms by organizations come from individuals within those organizations who are also prolific users of those platforms themselves and understand what they're good for and what they're not, because there's clearly, you know, very different uses for each one, and you kind of need to have that personal experience in order to be able to judge that.